Nicholas Seawright from NBA.com is in Philadelphia and joins us for the latest on Steph's march to three-point history. Michael, Steph is 33 years of age. No signs of slowing down at this point, but you got to be concerned about minutes to some degree. To what degree will Steve Kerr's concerns affect his pursuit of this record over the next few days?
Well, I think Steve Kerr said that the biggest thing for Steph to break this record is just not focusing on it. You know, you just play ball and it's going to come. So that is sort of the least of their concerns right now. But Steve Kerr did say that they really have to be conscious of Steph's minutes because, as you said, he's getting older. He's 33 years old. He's playing like 34 minutes a game. And, you know, with the style of play that he's out there doing, you know, he's running around a lot. I mean, there's a lot of running. And so, you know, there's a lot of tread on the tires, too. So you got to be careful about that. And Steve Kerr said that's something they're going to monitor moving forward. But he did say this. He said that Steph says he's feeling great, and he's felt great pretty much all season. So they haven't really had to worry too much about managing those minutes. But, you know, on this road trip, you know, they've got another, three games here on the road. And so they're going to be thinking about it here moving forward. And I think a lot will depend on what goes on tonight. Like, yeah. say he doesn't break the record. And say they play a tight game and they win the game. I think, you know, you sit him. It'll be something like that, I think.
Yeah, they got three games in four nights on this road trip. I'm sure Steph would love to do it with his brother Seth in the building in Philadelphia tonight. You know, nobody wants to be on the other end of a record broken like this as an opponent. And for Doc Rivers, it just happens to go hand in hand that his goal of winning the game probably also coincides with his goal of stopping Steph Curry from making a whole bunch of threes. So what is the plan to slow him down tonight?
Well, you know, Seth, Steph's brother, he knows Steph's game better than anybody. And he said that the key is to consistently pressure him. You know, you got to run with him. You got to run all over the plate, all over the court with him. And you have to be consistent in that. Like, if you stop him or slow him down in the first quarter, you can't be content with that. You got to do that. Doc, I have to look at it because it was funny what he said. You know, he was saying that, you know, we're gonna do everything we can to get over the top of screens. We're going to switch everything correctly. He said, but at the end of the day, if it was that easy, I wouldn't be sitting here right now talking about Steph Curry like this. So, you know, and you got to remember, Doc coached Ray Allen. So he knows all about shooters, and I'm sure he's got some pretty good plans to slow down Steph. But, you know, I think with Steph, I mean, it's not just about him. You know, all of his teammates are going to have to help him to get that done. You know, you're talking about Wiggins, Jordan Poole, Draymond, all those guys. I mean, it all works hand in hand. Steph's not going to be doing this by himself. So if he does get it done, his teammates are going to have a lot to do with it, too.
Absolutely, and it's worth mentioning the Warriors are 21-4 on the season, so it's not like any of it has been easy so far for coaches against the Warriors. Steph, by the way, took 17 threes in the win on Wednesday night against Portland. So Steph Curry, not surprisingly, is at the top of the MVP ladder, which you put together on NBA.com. What's it going to take for somebody to knock him off that perch anytime soon?
Well, you know, a big part of MVP ladder is team success. So, you know, it's going to take somebody to knock these Warriors off. And like you said, they're on a roll right now. And, you know, it seems like they haven't even gotten to – they haven't even reached the point to where they're going to be as good as they're – you know what I mean? They haven't peaked. They're going to get better. And, you know, because you're waiting on Klay Thompson to come back. You're waiting on, you know I can't think of his
James
name
Wiseman.
Right now. Wiseman, James
yeah.
Wiseman, yeah. You're waiting on him to come back. And so they're going to get better when those guys get in there and they start building some chemistry with the whole team together. And so that's sort of the scary thing about the Warriors, that they have such a good record and they haven't even peaked yet.
Yep, 21-4 without a Hall of Famer in the lineup and without a likely starter in the lineup coming back sooner rather than later.